wherever you are, whoever you are. This is a miracle. Miracle happens. And I just saw that. Own eyes. Cheers.
What did you say?
Nice. Lives getting transformed and barriers getting broken. Totally. It's like a mindset that just broke totally. I mean, it's like you were in front of a storm that happened and you didn't even think the storm had happened, but it's right there and it's happening and you're watching it and you can do the same. So fucking come. You know what I mean?
Saturday, day 4 of the residential retreat in Bali. It's hot out. So are the girls. Let's go find, let's go mingle, let's go Sarge. Set a second if you need it. Over here. I'll leave you two to work the set.
Trust me, guys, I need to introduce you to my friend.
Hello. My name is John.
Yeah, my name is Lachie.
Hello,
yeah. Nice to meet you.
Are you Ukrainian?
No, I'm Russian.
Very well.
This is my good friend Rob. Rob.
Hello.
Is from
nice
London.
To meet you.
Nice to meet you.
This is the nightclub owner. Okay. And this is one of the smartest magicians in the entire world.
Okay.
This man, not even here. This man was voted the sexiest man in Colombia.
Swedish kingpin.
He's a drug dealer. London, Colombia. Any drugs? Ooh. He's the man. Shaggy, the top one.
He's the
And I am from the same place
yeah.
that brought you, Justin Bieber. Where am I from?
Ooh. Belarusia.
Hell.
Oh. Yeah,
Canada.
This is funny, really.
Canada, Toronto.
Yeah.
But I lived in Hollywood 10 years.
In Hollywood?
Yep.
Yeah. I have friends in Hollywood, yeah.
Have you ever been to Hollywood?
No, I just in the process to do my...
She hasn't got much experience. I'm teaching her. I'm trying to teach her
paperwork now.
Yeah.
Right? To get to Hollywood?
Yeah.
If you ever do go, climb to the Hollywood sign and touch it for good luck. Trust me, it works.
Okay.
Fair.
You need a little bit of good luck. I can tell, you know, you're struggling a little bit. That's right. Apology accepted. Now, the ring trick, that was pretty good.
Oh, yeah.
But he has an amazing ring trick, even better.
All right, I'll show you some.
Yeah, he told me a lot of time about
actually,
doing...
Press my elevator button.
Okay.
Come show the friends, come with us.
We'll go back to the friends, show. Come on.
Okay.
Let's go back.
Guys, I need to introduce you to my friend. He's one of the most successful nightclub managers in the UK.
Thank you.
Thank you. No, wrong hand.
Oh my god, she doesn't know anything.
And quit. No, come on.
Push. There we go. My niece taught me that.
I'll try again.
Alright, don't fail me. Oh my god.
No,
gently. Push.
Yes.
Break your heart.
Why?
So you opened the set. It was a four set, two guys, two girls.
Yep. So
beautiful girl.
Four set of Russians. The blonde, easily a 10.
You opened with a tattoo opener.
Yeah, so opened with a tattoo opener.
And then what?
I opened the guy. Didn't speak a lick of English because he was an obstacle. So I immediately went over to the other obstacle and the other guy. They were loving it. They were lapping it up. They were chatting. The target tried to jump in multiple times. So I threw a couple of negs, dismissed her, throw and go back to the obstacles. And one of the obstacles, the girl, was very smiley. So I said, you know what? I can already tell you have an amazing personality because you smile so big. I said, high five. High five. Look at my elbow. Look at my elbow. Come on. There we go. That's how you high five. And then we went back into it. And so she was starting to like try to like get my attention. She was just standing up and moving around, like coming at me. Then I was like, okay, I'm gonna do the ring trick. Yeah. So I got up.
Not the ring trick.
The ring, ring miracle.
Ring miracle.
Yes.
Ring flight. It's called.
Ring flight.
The ring flight gambit.
Yeah. Ring flight.
It's a ring flight.
Yeah.
Fair.
Yeah. Ring flight. I can't remember the exact line I used. I said something to make it seem normal that I was standing up and going around to her. I think it was a neg. I think it was something along the lines that she can't dance because she was like going like this. And I'm like, that's not how you move your shoulders. I'll show you how you move your shoulders. So I got up, walked around to her, and the guy had his phone. So I was just like, hey bro, can you take a photo while I show her to dance? And then I gave him the phone and then we took a photo. And I was like, you know what? Slap my ass. Let's show you how it's done. And then she slapped my ass. We all started laughing. And then I did the ring flight. And the ring flight trick.
But you also did this one first.
Yes, I did that one first.
Okay, so tell them about that.
Yeah,
one.
So I said, all right, I'm going to show you. I'm actually with one of the world's greatest magicians. I'm going to show you something he showed me. This is a big money stunt. This is in Las Vegas. Headline shows this is what he does. So I stood up, and then I got her to do the hand. She wasn't doing it very well at first, so I instructed her how to do it properly. And then I looked her in the eyes, I said, this isn't a magic trick, I just love it. And then they all started laughing.
Yeah, she burst into laughter.
Yep, which is good fun. And then I tried, so I was like, oh, no, that's all right, I'll show you something for real. And then I pumped it up again with a little bit of hype talk. And then I noticed that people on all the daybeds around were watching it.
Yeah.
And so then I just did the ring fly trick and like pumped it up, made it seem stupid. I gave the ring to the obstacle, the first guy opened. I'm like, is it a real ring? Feel it, just check it, make sure. And then I gave it to the target and she's like, ooh, a nice ring, very nice. And then she saw my black nails and so she started feeling my hands and at the nails. I was like, my nails are nice, maybe I can show you how to get some nice nails one day. And I went to the other male friend. I was like, whose nails are better? Anyway, so then I cut that thread, opened up the ring fly trick again, did it. They all thought it was hilarious and laughed. And then, I was so in the moment, it's hard to remember.
Yeah,
that's right.
Then I think I asked them, how do you guys all know each other? And I think we're talking about Russia and where they're from. And I said, oh, I don't trust Russians. There's too many Russian spies. And then I went back to the other obstacle. I was like, but not you. I like you though. And I gave the DHD again to the, or IOI to the obstacle. And like by now, she was like really, I could tell the energy shifted. Like she was really pumped up. So I sat down and I said,
at one point you did the arm and arm.
Yep.
Brought her over here.
Yep. So before that, I said, oh, I'm conducting a research experiment. I'm asking people what their favorite photos are. I said, I'm conducting a research experiment. Give me your phone. To the blonde one. And I was like, open up your Instagram. She opened up the Instagram. And I'm like, you know what? What are you guys actually doing later on? So I kept trying to like cut threads and do multiple open loops.
Yeah.
And she was like, oh, good. I'm not really sure what we're doing. We're just going to hang out with friends. And then the guy jumped in. He's just like, yeah, we're having heaps of fun here, but we're not really sure what to do later. And so then I invited the guy. I said, oh, we've got a VIP at a really nice club. Later on, you guys are more than welcome to come. He's like, oh, that would be amazing. And I was like, oh, okay, cool. Well, I'll give you my contact information. And then I said to blonde, here, pass me your Instagram, and I'll give you contact information. We can meet up later. And she's like, yep, sure, let's do it. So I closed her. And then I said, while you're here, show me the your favorite and worst photo. And then she...
Did you hear that? Show me your favorite and worst photo.
Yep.
You said that to her.
Yeah, you open up their Instagram and say, I'm going to pick two photos and heart them. One of them will be my favorite, one will be my least favorite, and it's up to you to decide which is which.
Except that's the gambit that I use, but this is like
a little bit different.
A little different.
A little different. So I got her to pick her favorite photos of mine.
Same. Good stuff.
Yep. And so she did that. And then I said, if you guys love that, you're going to love meeting my friends. I'm over there with some of the smartest people in the world. Here, come on. I'll introduce you to them. And then I brought her over, arm in arm, and then obviously introduced you guys. And then brought you back over to meet their friends. Yep. So merge sets.
I did a couple pieces of magic.
Yep.
Real ring flight twice. And then the scarf through neck. And then I left the set so he could continue it himself. And that was that.
Show you that if you open enough, you're gonna get some that are like really friendly, and it's gonna open up without being very good at it. But you're gonna get all the experiences, and you just have to keep trying. Like if you get blown off, you have to just keep going at it. Like,
yeah, and stick to your material.
Yeah, because right. Before that, I opened another Russian, and she was very cold, and she was like. I was like, glasses on, and she's like, I think you should go or something, and I'm like, where are you from? She's like, Russian. I'm like, oh, no wonder. I heard that Russians are very cold in the start, but they open up. And then eventually she's like, oh, what's your name? She wanted to, like, she talked a bit more, but then she's like, okay, Sam, I think it's time to go, and then... So I just left.
That was a different one. That wasn't that set though. That was a set when? Yesterday or?
No, right now.
Before the set that hooked.
Yeah.
Can I see that one again? Can I see that girl again?
Yeah.
Whoa. Nice.
There was this cute chick on the beach on her phone, just sitting there.
How long?
The set? Like 30-40 minutes.
By the beach. Did you run criteria?
No, because I found out she already had a boyfriend and she's committed. I could have ejected from the set earlier, but I still wanted to practice like other stuff.
Yeah, she doesn't have a boyfriend. You just had her say that, I think.
Tell us, I heard she bought you a drink.
Yeah. She got me a bintang. And she was laughing a lot when she's with me. She was smiling a lot, so I had fun talking to her. And I tried to invite her to the party tonight, but she's more of like a nature person. But I said like it's a good way to, like, she's alone here, so it's a good way to meet new people and socialize.
But later she's like, I have to go book 9 a.m. in the morning tomorrow, and I want to do some yoga, so I'm not coming. But I said, I took her IG and just said that we can be IG buddies. And it felt nice talking to her because I was in my head the whole day.
Yes.
And I felt like when I was more comfortable, my personality could be seen. Like, I was more vocal, I was cracking some jokes, getting her to laugh.
Good.
And I wanted to be in that state, so I remained in set, and it's gonna help me for the night.
Yeah, don't you feel like you had a breakthrough?
Yeah.
Good. You did it. You had a breakthrough.
But you could have done the three criteria because you had nothing to lose and everything to gain. It might have changed the game.
I was too analytical about it, but for the girls it's the emotion, like what they're feeling right now. So I could have gone with it, and the worst case scenario, it's good practice. And
stick to the material.
Stick to your material.
I should have done it.
That's the critique we have for you.
Because in my head I was like, she already has a boyfriend and she wants to be committed, and if I do the three criteria, like the lush smelling hair, it's gonna be weird. So I didn't go for it, but like you said, there's nothing to lose and everything to gain. So, and it would have been good practice, so I should have practiced it.
Hey, well, where you have the momentum of coming out of a set, why don't you open another one?
You may be tired,
yeah,
but that's okay.
Have some water.
There you go.
You will open another set. Sure, it's early.
Don't think, do.
Honestly, it's got dark now. The game's different, as Mystery just said.
The game is different when the sun goes down. They're in a different headspace now.
That's a huge miss!
Indeed.
Yeah.
Like, this was so packed compared to the other one.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
But you know, they're connected. If you walk by the beach, you'll reach the Atlas Club.
Like, yeah, exactly. Yeah. We've got both clubs now to bounce between.
Yeah.
That's how we roll, man. Two clubs.
You're the one with the contacts, with the connects for the VIP stuff. As men, if you see someone who can give you as value, they will want to be friendly. Yeah, they will want to be
friendly.
Don't
take value.
Yeah,
value.
Don't take, give. Yeah.
Like, yeah. And they'll give back tenfold. Yeah.
Right.
Do you want this back?
I just hold on to it.
Okay, if I want something, I'll just come and grab it.
Okay.
It's all yours.
All good?
How are the boys going?
Great. One's doing amazing over there with a whole like 12 set.
Really?
And Shabam closed a lovely girl who's coming out tonight.
Oh,
so it looks like we're going to have a big old party.
Very nice. Make sure I get an invitation, please.
You're on the guest list?
Yes.
What's your name? I've been down this street with the girls' name Emily, so We're just gonna have to take some social distancing here, maybe like 30 centimeters. Is that okay? But I can give you a high five.
Lachie was in set, I went in, winged him, there was a free set of girls, and then Mystery came in, and then we were all, you know, playing with the sets, doing the star routine, the fish, you know, just joking, vibing, negging, everything, and they were loving us, IVDs, and I said to her, come on, let's go and make some friends, went out, went a bit of dancing, and some Russian guys that liked her came over, and he was whispering like that, and I went, and I just said to her, needy, like that, and she felt that he was needy.
She said,
I went, needy, because he's leaning in. And then one other Russian came over, tried to chat her up, and was like looking at me funny. They'd obviously been talking to her earlier, buying her drinks. So I just, and he went to try and touch my hair, moved his hand, he went to try and touch her, moved his hand. And then she went, she turned to him and went, we're married. She said to the guys, we're married. And I had my ring on, and I went, yep, look.
She said that to the guy.
Yeah, that we're married. And I went, look, there's my ring, and I showed the ring. And I went, come on, dear, like that. And I went, and as he walked by me later, he went, fucking fuck, fuck, fuck. And I just laughed. And then she introduced us to a table that had a bottle, and she went, this is like my sugar daddy, but I don't do anything with him. Like that. And then the guys were giving us drinks. And fun night.
What an experience you had, and you have had through all these years. Because your mind right now is trained, like, there's no barriers. There are no barriers.
There's always a move.
However, there is nothing water.
Miyagi, though.
Okay. No matter how I'll have it.
Yeah. Wow. It's okay. There's always a move.
Thanks.
How many moves do you know? The more sets you do, the more moves you know. Unconscious competent kicks in. You don't block, it blocks. Yeah. Bruce Lee. So it's all field experience, man. It's all field experience.
Approach and explore.
Yeah.
And handle. Yeah. Honestly, you might want to
handle the interrupt, external and internal. Make friends.
And you might crash, but then you're gonna know in the next set.
Merge sets. Backwards merge, forwards merge.
It's quite hard for me. I mean, you probably know, right? You already had that one much earlier in your career.
My blow.
I
had their experience.
And I went to bed and I woke up the next day. I just sat there and I was like,
oh, I'm at Beckster. Nice.
Everything's changed. You got a game plan of getting the merge.
That was a good set.
That was, we were the good time at that place. Like, we went in, I was like, it's changed because now I can go into a venue by myself, not knowing anyone, and instantly walk over and get the hottest girls locking me in, laughing at me, grabbing me.
Yeah, laughing with you.
Laughing with me, sorry, with me, grabbing me, this is chasing me. Like, that's, it was a big shift.
What's going on with these ones? Let's follow up.
I have followed up.
Because I like her.
She replied.
Yeah.
She replied, this one. She said, how's it doing, coach? She saw the link on my bio.
Oh!
And she put hearts and everything.
Ah, nice.
Oh, she didn't.
That's a, it's a no, DHV.
It's a DHV. Is it?
Yeah, yeah. Leader of men.
Leader of men.
Is it?
Successful risk taker.
It is.
Entrepreneur.
Yeah, okay.
Entrepreneur.
True.
It's good.
True.
Trust me, it's good.
True. It is?
Yeah.
They might shit test you at the start.
That's right.
They're like, oh, so what's your pickup line?
But never flinch.
So what do you say?
Don't apologize for it.
How have some of them shit tested
you? I'm very good at what I do.
Show them your girlfriend.
Well, and then they go, and then one day they'll go, how did you do that?
Yeah.
And then you go, gotcha, bitch.
Gotcha, bitch.
Crazy. How'd you do that? How'd you get a girl that hot?
Well,
I just talked to her. I don't know. Ladies just like me. I don't know.
They're like, no, tell me.
Before I came here, after I'd obviously met the book and like done a little bit by myself over a couple weeks, a couple of my friends, I have a couple of naturals that have no idea what they do, but do relatively well, but not tens. Like,
I haven't been to them.
Maybe like a decent looking chick at a bar.
They have gambits. They just run the same. They have stories that are the same. They just don't know it's that. But they don't know what they do wrong.
Well, the thing is, they don't have the ability to be like, she's sitting over there, she's the hottest, I want her, I'm gonna get her. It's more like a
random bump.
Random bump on the dance floor. Like, it's more of like a natural game plus luck. It's not a natural game, I'm gonna get her. It's a if it happens, it happens. But, and I tried doing a few routines before I came here, just on my own. And all of them just
Well, let's look at it this way. Let's be realistic here. How many sets you do today?
1, 2, 3, 4, 6.
How many number closes or contacts closes did you get?
6. Coming here and this experience, you can't put a price tag on that. If someone comes here and does it properly, there's no price tag you can put on completely changing your entire life and shifting your identity to a higher level.
We go away to hot climates, and that's when you have the opportunity to come where it's a target-rich environment in lovely weather, in paradise, and practice the elegant art of seduction, attraction, and comfort, but not in them orders.